they'll have more time for their children. Okay? Parang counterfactual, di ba? Or counterintuitive. The equation that I could think of is that because they don't have to work outside, they have less time working outside, then they can take care of their children more. This one is beneficial. And then, women who have access to electricity spend more time on housekeeping. So why? So, again, it might be income effect because if they have electricity, then they have more electrical appliances, they have more things to clean. So, we spend more time cleaning or doing housekeeping. Okay. Women in households that utilize LPG relative to wood users, consistent with the labor outcomes, they have more time working outside. And therefore, they have less time tending animals and less time sleeping. Okay. If we use GLM, the GLM results are not consistent with the literature. For example, women in households that use wood for cooking spend 2.7% more time on food preparation. Assuming that gathering wood and preparing wood for cooking is part of food preparation. Therefore, wood users spend more time on food preparation. Relative to wood users, kerosene users spend less time on food preparation, like Marisol in the previous slide, and more time on other activities, okay, like tending animals, childcare, and then working from home. Questions? And then the same with LPG users. Mothers now have more time working outside. And then those mothers that use electricity are also more likely to work outside. Okay. Housekeeping. Again, probably because of income. Okay, so in summary, for health outcomes, the results are robust. Whether we use fixed effects, random effects, and COVID. Better and cleaner energy access improves health of women. Okay. For labor outcomes, better or more efficient energy access improves labor force participation of women. For example, LPG users relative to wood users and those who use electricity over kerosene for lighting. So I'm just summarizing the results shown previously. For time allocation, the results that are consistent are as follows. One, better energy access reduces time of food preparation. For example, women that use electricity or kerosene. And they have increased time allotted on working from home and also working outside. In conclusion, that's it. Just to reiterate, cleaner and more efficient use of cooking fuel improves women's health. Cleaner, more efficient use of cooking fuel and modern access to energy, such as electricity, also improves the likelihood of women or mothers working. Okay. And engaging in micro-enterprises or self-employment. For time allocation, we found that the GLM results provide the more consistent results, you know, relative to existing literature. The use of particular energy variables over time can significantly affect the time allotted to childcare, food preparation, working at home, and working outside. So several limitations of the paper. One, we haven't conducted Hausmann tests, so formally yet fix and next one, have effects and prove it, just intuition. Second, it's actually more appropriate to use categorical variables rather than just simple binary variables. And for that, we're going to use another method called lab. Okay? And then another improvement is how to proxy for income effect in the house, in the regressions. Another further research would be, because this is just for Cebu mothers, we cannot generalize and then see all the mothers in the Philippines. To be able to do that and create the panel, we have to construct a longitudinal data from NDHS, for example, or HEX. But in order to do that, it's not going to be at the household level analysis, but at the municipality GP analysis. That's it. Thank you.
Yeah, I think you have cooking fuel, or cooking, and there's several technologies, wood, electricity, kasama ba dun? LPG. The three types of energy sources for cooking.
Cooking fuel, lighting. Cooking fuel, source of lighting, and then
the lighting is another matter. Just cooking.
Cooking, LPG,
wood,
kerosene.
Okay, kerosene. Yeah, I think I've raised my first earlier point about the importance of income. Because cleaner energy, there's an access issue.
Yes.
Can you afford it?
Yes.
If you're really that poor, it's of course, it's very important to have access to cleaner energy, but you can't afford it. So you're poor, so you are going to be using wood, So at least you can get a profile of the because they may not even have even in the labor market the profile to enter the labor market because they're that poor.
Okay.
So it's. Although I'm not belittling the important point that some energy sources are more polluting and therefore have a deleterious outcome, so that's an important point. But whether it's really that only, or you can actually probably mitigate that, allocate the explanation if you have another controlling variable.
I understand because we can have this entanglement.
Right.
Siguro that's another way to find proxy for income, maybe
My other point is this, now that we have these estimates, I think it's important to do some simulation. Because if the government would like to do something about access, because we have poverty is with us, are they going to subsidize this or? Can we really bring down electricity prices so that even them can actually avail of electricity or LPG or whatever, so what are the benefits? I mean, how many women are we talking? How women is involved in actually using wood-based cooking or something like that? So if we generalize this, I know that you are controlling, this is just Cebu, we can't generalize it. But suppose we use that one, how much of the population women are affected by this? And what would be the sort of health cost associated with that kind of, is that something that the government can actually be concerned about doing something about this? Yeah. Rather than end, you're with just estimates. So implications of that as well.
Yes. So that's not yet part of the policy implication and also the economic implication. It's not yet. I haven't yet translated into that. So that's the next.
It's going to be another paper, but just to relate it to, okay, what should we do now?
Thank you.
If I may contribute. I guess I appreciate the fact that you need established statistically robust results. But you also, for policy implications, the results should also have compelling numbers. So if you just have 3% or 1%,
yes, so that's
not compelling.
That's another issue, because it's just a small percentage. So another task is converting that, to like what Professor Fez said. So what if they set the numbers, the set of coefficients? I recognize that the magnitudes are small for now. But also we're just looking at Cebu data. So it's very hard to generalize. Also, it's important to note that there's a large percentage already of Cebu mothers who have access to electricity. So only a small percentage actually have that access to electricity. So that is affecting the small damage. So there's not enough variation in the source of energy.
I was just wondering if this study would have been conducted in a more rural area, say for example, Castro provinces or areas where this one is, Cebu is basically a urban area, and of course the access to wood as fuel or something would be much less.
Yes.
I was wondering if this study would have been done in a far more rural areas with the results would be more significant.
Obviously, it would be more significant. I've considered that because you shift more from no access to access would be more pronounced in rural areas. But then I was more after the data set, tracing the households, hence the small magnitude. But I do recognize that using rural areas will probably produce a higher, more significant effect. Kaya lang we don't have data. We don't have data for rural. We can do that if we use national data set, pero municipality level, not household. So maybe that's the next step also. Other questions?
No. Okay, so I believe Monica and Francie distributed the EPDP evaluation form.